If you want to learn how to add quizzes to Microsoft Teams, then keep on watching. Hi, my name is Tony, and this is my channel, Ready Steady Excel. If you want to learn more about these applications here, then by clicking subscribe and hitting the bell, we'll put you on the right path. Quizzes are not only fun, but they can also be used to help test people's understanding and can help to make your meetings more engaging. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a quiz, how to add it into your channel in Microsoft Teams, and then at the end, we're going to look at how to collect the results and how you can download this into an Excel spreadsheet. Are you ready? Then let's go. Okay, so let's start by creating our quiz. And to do this, I'm going to use another application called Microsoft Forms. Microsoft Forms is available to anyone that has a Microsoft 365 account. So this could be a school account, work account, or your own personal account. Although with the personal account, some of the settings might be missing. We've got two options here. We can create a new form, and this is what you would use if you wanted to create a survey or a poll. And I'm going to cover that in a separate video. But they work in a similar way to a quiz. The only difference is, or the key difference is that you can't have a right or wrong answer in a survey or poll. So let's do our quiz. I'm going to give my quiz a name, and this one's going to be a movie quiz. Description is optional, but I'm going to throw one in. Let's start adding our questions. So I click Add New. Got a choice of different types of questions that I can ask. So I'm going to go start off with multiple choice. Type in my question. So for this one, I've put in what color. And as you can see, it's given me suggested options for the answers. This also works when I do what day. Let's continue with what color. So I've got the question in. So now let's put in the answers. So I'm going to click on here. So blue, yellow, let's do green. I also have the option to add my own sort of manual ones here if I wanted to, but that's fine. Now, when I hover the mouse pointer over these answers, you get these three icons on the right-hand side. So the tick is how you show which one is the correct answer. So yellow is the correct answer. How many points is this question worth? So I'm going to say this is worth one. Further options I've got down here at the bottom is that I've got multiple answers. So maybe there's more than one that's correct. I can make it required, so they have to complete this question. But I'm going to leave this one as optional. And then let's click Add New to add another question. I'm going to go for another multiple choice one. And let's put in my question. And let's put in the possible answers. And again, remember to select which one's the correct answer. Now you've got a speech bubble here, and this allows you to put in why this answer is correct. So when the user gets their results, they will see this. Now, just to touch on some other options that you have available. So down here, I've got more options. So I can choose to shuffle the options. I can choose to turn this into a drop-down list rather than radio buttons. I can then turn it into a maths question. I can add a subtitle, or I can add something called branching. Now, branching, I'm going to cover in a separate video, but what this allows you to do is set rules for these questions. So based on the answer to this question, we'll take the user to another question. Okay, let's click Add New to add another one. This time it's going to be a text-based question. So this one's not a multiple choice question, so I need to add what the answer is going to be. Do you know the answer to this question? From Russia with love. And I'm just going to click away, just click here, and I'm going to add another answer. So I will also accept Russia with love. The answers are not case sensitive. Now there is an option here to say long answer. So for these ones, it allows a person to put in a longer answer. Now with this one, you will need to check the answer manually when the responses come through. So that's why you don't have the option to add the answer. So you need to manually check it yourself. Now just to finish off this quiz, the last one I'm going to do is rating. So for this one, you can choose the levels. So this one is set to 5, but I can increase that if I wanted to. Let's keep it as 5. You can also choose the symbols. You can either have stars or numbers. So I'm going to keep it as stars. Down here at the bottom, if I go to more options, this time I'm going to go to label. So 1 star would be poor. And 5 stars, I'm going to say amazing. This one's not really a quiz question. It's more for feedback. So I'm not going to award any points for this. I'm just going to put 0. So there are other types of questions that you can add to your quiz, which I'm not going to use today, but you've got date, you've got ranking, you've got Likert, file uploads. With file uploads, to answer a question, the user would then need to upload a file. You've got net promoter scores, you could break up your quiz into sections. So you could have a section on actors, action movies, horror movies, as an example. Before you share this quiz, you can go to preview, and this allows you to test out your quiz. You can also see how the quiz looks on a mobile. And if you click back, this will take you back to the quiz. You've also got themes. So if you want to add a bit of color to your quiz, then you can. So the range of options available here. Over here, you've got settings. So let's have a quick look at this. So you've got a range of options available here. So you can show the results automatically. So when the person completes the quiz, they get the response straight away. Down here, you can make the quiz public. So anyone with the link can view the quiz. If you're using an image-based question, then you won't be able to make this quiz public. Also with this public option, when people complete the quiz, they're anonymous. So you might want to add a text-based question to capture their name and email address. Whereas if you're sharing this quiz around your organization, automatically it will record their name and their email address, but you can deselect that option if you wanted to. You've also got the option here that people can only complete the quiz the once. So in the next section, you've got options for responses. So the first one that's ticked is accept responses. So whenever you want to close off the quiz, you just simply deselect that option and you would then put in the reason why the quiz is closed. I'm going to leave this one on. You can also set a start date, an end date. You can shuffle the questions. You can put in a thank you message. You can also choose to send or receive a notification. Next up, we've got share. So again, up here, you could choose to make it public or just keep it to your organization. You've got the option to copy the link here. You can do a QR code. You can embed it into your website. You can send it out as an email. You've also got options here to share your templates, and you can share this quiz with others so they can add their own questions. Now, when it comes to adding it to Teams, you don't need to use this link option here. You just simply go to Teams, click on your channel. So I've got a channel here called Team Quiz. Click on the plus, and I click on Forms. I can create a form from scratch, but I'm going to add an existing one. Got my movie quiz here. And down here at the bottom, I want to collect the responses. But the other option you've got here is show results. So if you want to create like a results page, then you could do that. So I'm going to show you that in a moment. Let's do save. So here's the quiz for people to complete. And let's fill this one in. And rate this quiz 5 stars. Click submit. As the person completing this quiz, I've got the option here to view the results. But what I want to do is show you, as the person that created this quiz, what they see. So if I go into forms, let's click on movie quiz. See that I've got one response. I can click here. It gives me like these pie charts. I'm a one-man team today, so there's only one quiz completed. But over here, I can go to review the answers. So I can either review the answers by people or by questions. I've got the option here to delete the responses, to print, or to post the scores. Now, the way I set this quiz up, people get their scores straight away. But if I hadn't set it up that way, then I can choose to post the scores. Over here, I've got various options. So I can delete all the responses. Maybe I was using this for testing and I want to start again. I can print a summary. I can create a link to this summary page as well. You've also got the option to download it into an Excel spreadsheet. So let me show you this. So this is the information you would see. So you've got some really useful information there. So you've got things like the start time, completion time, you've got their email address, their name, and you've also got their scores and how they've answered the questions. And obviously, if more than one person had completed this quiz, you would get the list of all the responses here. Now, if you wanted to, you could add a results page to this channel. And to do that, click on the plus, click forms, go to add existing, click the quiz. This time I'm going to go show results, click save. So you would do this to add the results into your channel. This is the video that I want you to watch next. And this is the video that YouTube wants you to watch next. And if you haven't already, then please click subscribe. I will see you in the next video.